Tuesday, the 25th of February. It's 7 p.m. It's time for Boombox of the Briggies. Welcome to the 15th instalment. It's the 15th Boombox of the Briggies that we've been partaking in.
Oh, I hear the ticking of the clock. I'm lying here in this pitch dark. I wonder where you are tonight. No answer on the telephone. And the night goes by so very slow. Oh, I hope that it won't end, oh, alone. Till now, I always got by on my own. I never really cared until I met you. And now it chills me to the bone. How do I get you alone? How do I get you alone? You don't know how long I have wanted to touch your lips and hold you tight. You don't know how long I have waited, and I was gonna tell you tonight. But the secret is still my own. My love for you is still unknown. Now, I always got by on my own. I never really cared until I met you. And now it chills me to the bone. How do I get you alone? How do I get you alone?
Good evening. Welcome back to the 15th installment of Boombox at the Brickies, the fourth episode of Boombox TV. We've got an awesome night planned already with Marsden Park and Like Optimists and of course the Lazy Eye Plan, but we've been lucky enough to grab Scott Clark, who will be playing very shortly before his set. Scott, it's good to see you again. It was only a few weeks back, I think, that we...
Last week.
Time's literally flown. So, last week when you were down here, literally just as a, you know, an audience member supporting, you know, live music as you've always done. Tonight you're down there playing, so it's a completely different ball game. And you are throwing yourself in the deep end as well tonight.
Very much the deep end. I have not picked up the guitar in about 6 months. Probably since October when I last played. And I've thrown some backing tracks together that I haven't tried out yet either. So it's all going to be fun and games tonight.
Flying without a safety net.
I was inspired by the rockiness of last week, so this week I thought, I'll do the little acoustic stuff, but I have to throw in a few kick-you-in-the-face songs.
Yeah, obviously you're no stranger to rocking out yourself, are you? Because you are the front man for an awesome local covers band as well. But
yes, Ransom for a Dead Man. We're playing Heartsease on the 14th of March. And we're also having it confirmed tonight, headlining the Airfest at the Brickies over the weekend of the 26th, 27th of September, I believe.
We're
on the Saturday night, 26th, in the B2.
Brilliant. The headline, of course, the Norwich Airfest 2020 year, resurrection of the festival from last year. It's going to be part of Vision, 2020 Vision, which is East Anglia's first touring festival, and you're going to be part of the first touring festival for East Anglia as well, which is awesome.
Yeah, I think I'll be involved several times down the line, because you keep inviting me back, it's great.
Well, I say definitely March the 14th. Heartsea is a lovely venue. I mean, you played there before, like, actually at Heartfest last year. And you know, it's a great venue, isn't it? So it'd be perfect for Ransom for a Dead Man, you think.
Really looking forward to taking the roof off the place, let's say.
Yeah, so we know we've seen the audience down there. They do like a good dance as well. They do like to chuck themselves along. And you've got quite a few sort of party bangers as well for the...
Planned. Judging by the last couple of crowds we had, there's definitely a few party bangers in there, and people will be getting up to dance and probably not sitting down again for the rest of the night.
That sounds like a promise then.
Well, let's hope.
Well, brilliant. I mean, we're probably very a short while now until you start playing, so we'd better let you get a chance to get yourself psyched up and ready. And so we'll say adieu to Scott Clark for the time being, and we're going to head back to some music.
You're watching Boombox Live.
The song will give that feeling.
Make me feel like I'm gonna feel.
Thank you.
You're watching Boombox TV.
Welcome back to the 15th instalment of Boombox at the Brickies. It's the fourth episode of Boombox TV, which has had an awesome set from Marsden Park, who are Janine Marsden and Tony Park, and we just happened to grab Tony for a quick chat. Good to see you again tonight.
Hello, Shannon. How are you?
Yeah, not too bad. How are you keeping?
Yeah, pretty good. Yeah, a lovely time.
How did you find it tonight with the set?
It's a lovely setup here, actually. Yeah, and we do enjoy ourselves. We only play where we enjoy ourselves, and it's good fun here.
Well, I would say, yeah, we've had a few gigs, a few venues now as well. So it was nice seeing with the addition of the bass as well.
Yes, which, our friend John Holden. Yeah,
has he not been with you?
No, it's the first time he's played with us.
Yeah,
we have a sort of a friendly gathering once a month at his place in Attleborough, and he offered to play bass with us this time. So it's a good addition. I was really pleased. Some of the harmonies went amazing with three of us. I never thought that would work.
And you had everyone a little bit spellbound with the We Will Rock You and Portishead mashup.
It's one of our specialities. Yeah. It's never the same twice, that one. We try not to be predictable.
No. So I know you obviously, you have previously played around Norwich quite a lot, Frank's Bar.
We've got sort of a regular spot, Frank's Bar. So I can't tell you when our next one is, but we're on their list. So we've on their rotation, we come every month or two there.
Yeah,
we like little venues. We've just realised we don't like doing big pub gigs.
Yeah.
It's too much like hard work.
It's like the intimate sort of
it's good fun.
Does suit the music as well. If you're there, it's very soulful in a sense. It's nicer in that sort of more intimate venue.
Mm.
And obviously, in terms of upcoming gigs, we've just confirmed the Saturday, the 25th of April. For the brand new Nelson Fest 2020.
Yes, we'd love to do that.
At the lovely, the lovely Nelson Pub in Norwich, Nelson Street.
Mm-hmm.
We'll look forward to catching you guys there. Will that be a duo, or will that be? Would you suspect?
Probably just the two of us, I think.
Yep.
Depending.
Yeah. So, John a regular yet, or is?
We don't have regular. It's like Frank, who plays with your band on the Cajon.
He plays
with us sometimes.
Frank Warner, King of the Cajon.
Yes, absolutely. Occasional guests.
There's always a surprise guest as well.
We'd
like to thank Tony for coming to speak with us today as well. And don't forget, you can catch Marsden Park next on the 25th of April at the Nelson in Norwich. That'll be a goodbye from myself and from Tony for now, and we're going to go back and see some music.
Yeah,
see
you. Thanks, Sharon. Nice one.
I'm not afraid to die.
company, always on the run. Destiny always rises up.
Thank you.
quite messed up relationships, as they all are, haven't they? This is so called Something Real.
Watching Boombox TV.
In your eyes.
Good evening. Welcome back to Boombox at the Brickies for the 15th instalment. It's the fourth episode of Boombox TV. We've had a cracking night tonight, and I'm very lucky to grab the headline act tonight, Like Optimists, who've come all the way out from Lowestoft to play for us tonight. I've managed to grab them at the end of the night and delay their journey home for a quick chat. So, hi guys, how are
hello.
We?
Hey, hello.
First ever Air Events gig. Enjoyed yourself?
Fun.
Yeah.
Well,
had a good time.
That is the.
People seem to enjoy themselves, which is the main thing.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. It's all enjoyment. And yeah. On a Tuesday night, coming all the way up from Lowestoft, you guys have got to be applauded for hard work. Do you know what I mean? Haven't seen you set. Loved the feel and the sound. I mean, how did you guys sort of first start? Sort of putting your sound together, or how did you first come together?
It was only just me and you at first, wasn't it? We were just
my bedroom.
We were in a covers band, and I just started writing songs. I've been writing songs for ages, and I said to you, didn't I? Do you want to start a side project? This was originally a side project, wasn't it?
I heard songs, and I just said, do you want to make
some tracks together, make some songs, and that was it.
So it's a side project was kind of like overtaking.
And everyone else come in after, sort of got the people we want. Got James, got Cameron.
When you guys first really cropped up on my radar was last year when you played at the Waterfront.
There was
quite a bit of a mental buzz that came through on social media, and I think you guys you've taken a bit of time off just to do a bit of recording.
Yeah,
we were just tracking, getting new songs out, a few
things happen along the way, people moving houses and stuff, kids.
Life getting away.
It seems to be getting back on it now, so it's good.
You enjoyed the last song of the set. You said that was the new release?
The End.
The
first time I've ever played it live.
Yeah.
First live.
Yeah, that was... Probably better than we could have ever expected, to be honest.
That one is available on Spotify as well. You've got quite a few demos.
Most of them are. There's a few we haven't released yet, but there's a lot on Spotify, Google Play, all that stuff. Everything. It's on there.
Excellent.
It's all on there.
Yep.
To buy or stream.
Brilliant job. I think in terms of next gig here in Norwich, we've confirmed on April the 10th with you guys.
Hopefully, yes.
All information was correct at time of filming.
Yeah.
I
think it's at Gringo's, isn't it?
Because you have got a festival coming up.
Carlfest.
Carlfest.
That's ran by Darren. That's an awesome festival. Yep. Really good festival. Every year, it's been on for, that's the ninth year, I think, this year. It's a big festival. For a small town, it's a massive festival, actually, isn't it?
It gets in the papers.
Yeah.
This year, I shall definitely become a nan. It's ninth year, I've got no excuse. So
yeah.
You are kind of familiar with the big three, big four of the Norwich venues. I mean, previously, last year, you were... Is it Epic as well as Warfront as well?
East.
I'm not sure whether I should say this in Norwich areas, but there was a the thing is there like a vicious rumour that you played at the Ipswich Town Football Club?
We did. I'm from Ipswich myself, so and an Ipswich Town fan. Sorry, everyone from Norwich.
No, we are completely all inclusive and diverse.
Thank God.
Absolutely. No,
we actually played after that gig. We actually played here. That same evening, did we? We watched the game. It was Ipswich versus Aston Villa, and we lost 1-0. That was like a dream come true for me because that was just amazing. I just come off the back of someone that I knew from school was just messaged me randomly on Twitter just saying, "Oh, by the way, the Ipswich Town are looking for people to play like in their fan zone for the game." I was like, "Oh yeah, let's get on that." So I messaged them and they were just like, "Yeah, sure," and just literally booked it in that week. We was like, "Oh, okay."
That sounds like a great.
So yeah, that was pretty fun.
He put it in the chat and we were like, "Please, please, please," and we were like, "All right, okay."
That's like a fantastic idea. I haven't heard of anything like that in Norwich. I've got to say, so that's, kind of leading the way in a sense, getting live music. I mean. Mm. You're looking at a captive audience of football fans, so
we actually played a couple of football favourites, like Chelsea Dagger and.
Oh yes.
Do we play Seven Nation Army? No, I don't think we do.
I think we messed about with it. We'd actually play.
I think so.
Messed around with what we
did.
It's a couple of football favourites to get the crowd going.
Vindaloo.
That was a really fun day.
Oh, brilliant job.
Straight back here to
do it again.
To do it again here, yeah.
So a double header on
we
the same day.
I can imagine.
I can imagine. So like,
slept well.
And crossing the Norfolk Suffolk boundary and divide all in one day.
Yeah,
so crossing all boundaries there. So no, brilliant job. I say thanks ever so much for staying right to the end, and I do apologise for the interview being so late, guys, and
that's
delaying
fine,
your journey home. But fantastic.
Had good fun. It was really good. Thank you for having us.
No, fantastic set, and we'll be seeing you April the 10th at Gringo's. All over Norwich very soon, I would imagine. Thanks.
Absolutely.
So from myself, good night. And from Cheers, like thank optimists, good night. Thanks ever so much for staying with us. Bye.
Thanks. This is a brand new song we've just released on Spotify and all that. Have a listen, it's called The End. We'll be right back. Thanks very much.
We are, we've come to the end of the 15th Boombox that we released. Thanks ever so much to Michael Optimus and all the live stuff. Mr. Marshall us tonight as well. Scott Chester at Belton Park as well, taking the laser eye guys. Cheers to Clive for doing a sound with us. Yeah. All you guys for staying to the end. And here we are at the final act of tonight, which is the Boombox loyalty draw. Nathan's kindly going to draw one out for us. My guys are completely excluded. It's completely for everyone who's just stayed to the end and bought a drink. The winner will take a £20 home, £20 note home with them. So,
let's have a round of applause though for everyone who's played tonight. Give up. The lucky number is 4-8-8.
Wow. Congratulations, boys. As promised, your reward for staying to the end, young fellow, my lad. Thanks so much for staying to the end. Yeah. Cheers, thanks so much to all of you, guys. Thanks for playing, traveling up as well. And thank you, Rob. We'll be back. These guys are back April the 10th at Gringo's. But we'll share that online, so thanks for giving yourself a round of applause, and thanks so much.
Well, we've had a fantastic night tonight, the 15th Boombox at the Brickies. Thanks for joining us. Thanks for staying to the end of this episode of Boombox TV. We'll have a short break for a couple of weeks. We'll be back March the 17th with the Rapalupus album launch. So thanks for joining us, and we're saying goodbye.